Hey, again about open source. I'm very often getting questions, and I'm questioning myself the same question actually, how to motivate the community to contribute to your open source project. I have a number of them on GitHub, and probably some of you have the same, and it's always interesting to see the real open source dynamics when somebody actually brings some changes to your project. One thing is that you develop it yourself, and the different story is when you have something there and then somebody who you don't know come to your project and start writing code for you and sending pull requests. But for most people it's not happening. For most people they just create something on GitHub, they publish it there and they stay for years with no contribution from anyone. And it happened to me as well. So basically mostly it depends on the amount of followers you have, the amount of people who follow your GitHub account. They are the primary sources of some changes and modifications to the code you write. And actually, if you don't know, if you don't have anybody there, if nobody follows you, then your chances are quite low. And I had the same for a few years, for many, like maybe 3 or 4 years, I had just a few followers and it didn't work for me. But if you still have a few followers, if you're not really like popular on GitHub, you still can get the contributors, you still can get some committers. And I think that the key to this success is the quality of your repository in the way you format it, not in the way of code you write. You may have some brilliant product which does, you know, interesting things, but the chances are quite low, in my opinion, that some stranger will see the great technology and interesting, you know, product, and they will just jump into, you know, giving you some help just because they like the technology. In most cases, they judge you by the quality of repository, by the way you maintain your code, and they make a decision whether it's worth helping you or your project is basically abandoned and is going to die in some time, in a few months or in a few years. That's how I make the decision. I think that majority of people make the same decision. They just look at how you format it. And I'm talking about your Readme file, that's the first. How you explain your project there, how well it's written, how many, all of those badges you have there, do you have continuous integration, do you have some metrics to analyze your quality, do you do static analysis? They look at the style of your repository. And if you follow the best practices of GitHub, look at the most popular repositories on GitHub, you will see how they are formatted. So try to copy them. They follow the best practices. They understand the habits of GitHub community and they do it right. I'm not saying right or wrong, but they do it the way they do it. So you have to copy them. And you have to make your repository look like it is already has a large community and it is formatted to the best standards of GitHub. So if you have, you need to have continuous integration, you have to need releases in your repository, you need to have tickets, you need to have pull requests. Even if you are alone there, if you are the only developer, you still may create the image, the impression, you can make an impression that your repository is active by making issues for yourself. You think about some new feature, make an issue for it. You make changes, you create a pull request, and then you merge a pull request. Even though you're alone, even though there is nobody else aside of you, then you still can imitate, probably that's the right word, imitate the activity there by using all the features of GitHub. They have issues, you use them. They have pull requests, you use them. They have releases, you use the releases. And this way you make your project more attractive to strangers because they will believe that their commitment, their contribution, which is free, will not be, you know, abandoned eventually. And the project will not die in a few months just because you are not interested in it. Because when you formatted it wrong, then you're giving a signal, you're telling your potential contributors that you don't really care about that. That's like something experimental. So you don't invest too much into making it look good. If you don't invest, why should we? So think about that and try to focus on that. Not only on writing code, not only on making the product right, but also on making it look right. Thanks for listening. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.